r/antiwork. Dot_no_where_i_am says. Job says $75 hour, but clicking to apply you see the actual job only pays $12 to $18. Included photo. Lynchase says. Employers are being scummy af in their job postings. They do this a lot with remote jobs. Then you click through to apply, and have to read the entire description, before you see this job requires you to be on location 5 days a week. I wish I could find the assholes who deliberately post lies to trick desperate people, and slap the shit out of them. They should definitely lose their ability to post jobs on LinkedIn. Make sure you report that. Matacaster_TM says. Or like when the job post has an easy apply button on LinkedIn, and there's a 95% chance the body of the listing tells you you need to email all your shit to a separate email address. Hate that shit. Lynchase says. Postings like that aren't serious about hiring people. I don't know what the game is, but you don't put up hoops to discourage applicants if you really need to fill a position. Nostradamus says. Isn't there a report post for false advertisement? Dot_no_where_i_am says. Not for false advertisement. I did report it though, see if anything happens. KX_ says. Report the post to LinkedIn. Motherfricks. Bastard_off_winterfowl says. $75 an hour on planet Venus. Sundeeban_official9024 says. Mid-senior level job for mid-poverty level wage. Afredbix says. Applied for a high level job with a salary in the post stating $85k-$90k. I was stoked, because I matched all the qualifications for the position. Had a phone interview, where they said it's not salaried, and that the pay was $21 to $24/HR. Frickin' waste of time. Ghost Piratesia says. That was a typo, we meant to offer $12. Robin X Hood says. In California too? Damn, I know CSR positions that pay $17-19 in the Midwest. Dotcomophob says. Absolutely despicable. Mystic_beam says. Why would they pay a customer service rep $75 an hour? Come on now, use common sense. Lmao. r/antiwork. Elemental Smurf says. Is it valid to leave a job because it doesn't feel right? I recently started a new job, and although I love the work itself, I don't feel all that comfortable around some of my coworkers. I have heard them make some disrespectful jokes towards women, and about people of different ethnicities. They are nice enough to me, but I just feel like I don't really want to be around people who think like that. I also have to travel quite a bit to get there, and don't love that aspect of it either. Even when I'm doing a part of it that I enjoy, there's still this lingering feeling that it just doesn't feel right. I'm just wondering if I'm being irrational in these thoughts, and whether it's enough to consider leaving for another job. I have been looking for other work, but it's been hard. I don't want to be without a job, but I also want to work somewhere where I'm comfortable. Calicut9 says. Work a job to pay the bills, while you find a job that you like. Misanth says. It's valid to leave a job for any reason that you have. You never need a reason, or an excuse, or to explain yourself. However, you do want to wait until you secure another job to quit. And please don't be too disappointed if the people at your next job are just like the ones at your current job. Wild Fury says. Sure. Just get a new job first before you leave. Technosapien says. It's at will. It's valid to leave a job because it's Monday. Silmeris says. It's valid to leave a job for literally any reason. Bamf1701 says. Yes, it is 100% fine to leave a job for that reason. Removing the specifics, and those are some really bad, disgusting specifics, what you have is a culture mismatch. And it is fine to leave a job if you feel their culture is not a good fit for you. That said, it is also completely legitimate for you to leave a job if the behavior of the management or employees makes you uncomfortable, such as making sexist or racist jokes. AbleHeat1797 says, "It's the best reason to leave a job. I know folks say get another job first. But that's what's always kept me stuck. Move when it feels right." Rakidify says, "I've quit jobs because I don't like the vibe." FDDFGS says, "You can quit a job for any reason you want. In a lot of places they don't even need a reason to fire you." M1ST3R51R says, "Yes, but always have a plan B, even if it's an inconsistent gig like DoorDash. The worst possible scenario is you quit somewhere without first having something else at least partially lined up. You could experience an unlucky cold streak with applications and interviews, leading to long-term unemployment without the unemployment benefits. This is increasingly likely if prospective employers require a positive reference from the employer or employers you walked out on. Most people quit their boss slash co-workers rather than the job itself. There is no shame in wanting to find a different place with a better culture." r/antiwork. Donut 113 says, "I work two jobs and still can't make ends meet. Genuinely thought about shoplifting socks today. Hi, it's me, the person who posted a couple weeks ago being in an abusive relationship, working two jobs and basically being a single mom, to not just my infant son, but to my deadbeat baby daddy whose parents were pretty much funding his whole lifestyle." Well, a couple days after I wrote that post, I came home one day after working to the apartment a complete mess. My son hadn't been changed, and my ex had left him in his pack and play and had just basically neglected him all day. I lost it, and pretty much told him I was sick of him blowing money on OnlyFans, and not taking care of our son. It ended with him screaming at me, and pushing me into a wall, and he kicked me in the stomach. He screamed at me how ugly I was, how the girls he pays on OnlyFans are better to him, how used and worthless I am, and I just had enough. I ended up taking my son and calling a domestic violence hotline, and a local women's shelter had a spot for me and my son 2 days later. I had to take us to a hotel while we waited for a spot to open up for us, but I just couldn't deal with being with him anymore. The shelter isn't so bad. I had to meet with the on-site social worker who helped me apply for WIC and Medicaid. I still make too much for SNAP all our income housing according to her, and I make too much for daycare assistance. I have a roommate who's made it clear she doesn't like that my son wakes up still in the middle of the night for a bottle, but we try to steer clear of each other. I'm the only one with a car which has been, wit. The other ladies living here constantly ask for rides to places, and get upset when I tell them no I can't do it because I need to save gas to get me back and forth to my two jobs. I've asked for more hours at my second retail job and was told no, so I'm on the hunt for either a full-time higher paying job or at least a second part-time job that will pay me more and give me more hours. It's been tough. I keep crossing my fingers I'll be approved for WIC and can maybe save what money I'm putting out for formula. Here at the shelter each of us have to contribute at least one meal a week. And there's a weekly chore chart we all have to keep up. I can't stay here longer than 120 days, so that's a worry of mine. I still don't make enough for a frick in one bedroom apartment for me and my son to share. I don't know if my ex will ever pay child support. I had to change my phone number upon coming to the shelter so my ex couldn't find where it's located, and I'm not allowed to share the address with anyone. And out of the three family law lawyers I called, two wanted a retainer that I can't ever afford, and the third never reached back out to me. I'm just so tired. I can't work more than 29 hours at my main job, and I legitimately contemplated stealing a pair of socks at Walmart when I was buying my son a new tub of formula because he was running low. I'm wearing some stranger's socks, at least they were washed, because I left with the clothes on my back and my son's diaper bag. I have nothing to my name besides what was in my purse and in my car when we left. I'm so tired of waking up from having nightmares of my ex raping me or kicking me in the stomach again. I want to be able to buy a new bra or a burger from Wendy's without being worried that it'll put me in the negative. I want to be able to buy my son brand new winter clothes, ones that fit, because he's outgrowing the three different outfits I have to cycle through. I would never steal, and I didn't do it today, because the last thing I need is a shoplifting charge against me, but goddam, I can't wait for this nightmare to be over. I've had anxiety dreams over winning the lottery and just starting fresh with my son, and never looking back, and never being involved with his crappy sperm donor. I know it'll be a miracle if I ever see a dime of child support once it's all said and done, but it is so sad and makes me feel like a piece of shit mother for struggling to buy just the bare necessities for my son and not even being able to buy myself a pair of new socks. I don't know where I was going with this, but I know a lot of people reached out, and I guess I wanted to give an update on everything. Here's to hoping life gives me a break and I can take a breather and maybe one day find myself out of throw away 88,556,784,324 says. It may be financially better to quit one part-time job to qualify for all of the assistance. There are scammers, and then there are people like you who genuinely need a helping hand to get on your feet. Tell them they fired you. If it's feasible, without the second job, maybe you can do online school to get a better job in the future. Dizzy_mirror2683 says. You don't need an attorney to collect child support. I don't know what state you're in, but in every one there's a state agency with attorneys that will get it and enforce it for you. And they're usually really good at it too. And it won't cost you anything. Clean Sheet Serenus says. You could try doing an internet search for free legal help near me and looking for family law help. Sometimes law schools will offer advice on what to do. They might have a free litoral that allows you to meet with a law student that can help you figure out what to do. They don't act as an attorney, but they can give you pointers. Pants Leo says. First, I'm so sorry you're going through this. Is there a university near you with a law school? A lot of law schools have legal clinics that will help in these types of situations for free. Please keep updating, and I'm sending all the best wishes your way. Interest Injects at 6696 says. You are so strong, take a deep breath. Everything you are doing is another step in the right direction. So don't give up, hugs to you and your baby. Unrefined Facade says. Do you know if you qualify for legal aid? An LSC organization should be able to provide advice or assistance to file for a protective order and or for child support. Not sure if the shelter mentioned them, but I hope you are able to get some help. Martin5791 says. Just curious, who initiated the divorce? Was there physical abuse, abandonment, adultery, addiction from either one? I'm divorced too, guess I just wanna feel better. Woodmana Legendro says. Steal from Walmart and never give it a second thought. That's all for this video, thank you for watching, please subscribe.